I tell you what, I know you're a busy girl. I thought I might actually get you doing some babysitting this afternoon.
Oh,
it'd be
aren't
good.
They heaven, couldn't
aren't
you just steal them? Absolutely delicious.
Would you like to have had more
children?
Oh,
I'd like 20. Yes, I'd like them now. In fact, I asked some of those mums if they didn't want them just for the moment. Just have a little hold. I think that's the thing, just have a little hold.
Before we talk about your new .com, I have to tell you I'm computer illiterate, but we will talk about that in a minute. I want to ask you about your life as the wife of a conductor, a very famous musical conductor. Mm. Is that an unusual feeling for you to go into that world?
It's extraordinary because it's sort of partly familiar in that they have great disciplines and timetables and the same sort of rehearsal periods and the stresses of performance. But in a way, they're so much senior to us as actors because all of them actually can do it. Do you know what I mean? All of us are blagging our way through it, kind of. Only Victor Spinetti doesn't. I mean, he's brilliant. But most of us are kind of thinking, I hope they don't discover me. Whereas all musicians and singers and dancers actually have a craft they can practice and they have to be good at. And although my husband's a conductor, of course, he's also a pianist. He can play French horn. He can play lots of instruments and things and understands all about bowings and things like this and says, down bow, please, and things like this. And I can't even read music, but I can follow it. But this is a singer, so she knows what she's talking about. It just seems to me to be a thrilling kind of combination, to be nearly like them, but not quite like them. And also, I respect him hugely for that.
I bet you do. Yeah. And also, when you're abroad, I guess, I mean, I know you're known worldwide, but maybe the height of it isn't just as much as here and maybe in America. But do you find yourself taking a kind of a more
back
role, subservient role?
Yeah, I'm the conductor's wife, and I always sit on my own at first nights at operas, just on my own, and going, thank you, no, thank you. And they go, oh, she's on her own, poor old stick. And you go, conductor's wife. So proud, so nervous, you know. Wonderful.
Mind you, in the arts world, I gather very soon, in fact, on this very channel, you're going to be showing us a private view, really, of Prince Philip's paintings.
Fascinating.
So how did that come about?
I was invited to do it, to interview people about their collections, people who are both interesting and have an interesting collection of paintings. And after Prince Philip, I talked to Lord Rothschild, who, of course, has the most extraordinary collections at his house. And there was something very wonderful because Prince Philip is really badly done by in the press. He's the kindest, friendliest, most courteous person, and somehow they always manage to get a horrible picture or to say something snidey. But he's so charming. He's so delightful, and he's so sort of light-witted and friendly. But he's a bit of a, you know...
Dish, you almost said.
I almost did, but, you know, les majestés, and I just think he's the most charming and delightful person.
But is his collection really impressive?
It was interesting because he's a passionate supporter of all kinds of Aboriginal art and life painting, you know, animal and bird paintings and things like this. He's rather a good painter himself, too.
And I hear you paint, too.
Well, humbly, but, yeah.
But you
I'm
like
interested,
it.
So interested in it, yes.
Now, listen, how has Patsy changed your life worldwide?
I kind of am bunching myself up to dare to go to Australia. They were so generous. I mean, the world has been fantastic to the show. But in Australia, in Sydney, every year at the Mardi Gras parade, they have a raft, a whole truck full of patsies. Men, most of whom are men, and all looking a great deal better than I look. So it's very sort of nerve-wracking when I go, and they'll go, oh, Patsy, you look really pony. Go and get yourself looking good, darling. So I'll have to just dress up a bit more. But it's been extraordinary because, you know, it's... People say, are you anxious about being typecast? The truth is, to be remembered for anything as an actor is wonderful because we all appear in a lot of things and we fly by, we're moving wallpaper a lot of the time.
But you're such a strong character. I imagine when you're doing your shopping in the local supermarket, you know, they're busy watching to see what does Patsy buy.
They've got used to me around there. They just go, oh, Joanna, there she is, a poor old thing, you know. Because I always look a bit ratty, a bit sort of scraggly, I mean. I'm as friendly as anything. And luckily, there are lots of people pushing their babies about. Oh, lovely baby, thank you. So it's very nice. It's very happy and very normal. But I think this country's not very starstruck, you know. I think we're rather good. I expect you're the same. Because you're a friendly person, Gloria. So when people come up and
I run after them and talk to them.
Oh, me too. I say, please stop and talk. And they go, I'm really busy, Joanna. Can you just not
stay? Go away, for goodness sake. But nevertheless, I mean, she is a heck of a character and one I should imagine that in one form or another will stay around in your life, I should think.
I think so. She's struck so many resonances with people and so many people have come up to me and said, oh, my best friend's just like you or I'm just like you or we're just like you too when we go out in the town. And my hair stands up slightly and I think, crikey.
But liberating as an
liberating.
Actress to play.
Oh, fantastic. Because up till then, really, I'd played an awful lot of smart people's girlfriends and well-dressed people in subtle clothes and... And there was something just... I think there's a bit of that kind of rebel in all of us, you know, just badly behaved. Well, I'm